And certainly if you've been watching WGN TV, you have seen Tom Negovan, ace reporter at WGN TV Channel 9, was dispatched to what? You don't like Ace Reporter?
Well, I think like it's Ace very
Reporter.
Kind.
I like Ace sure. Reporter.
Thank you.
It's better than some of the names I've heard about you in the newsroom.
Yeah, that's true, too.
So that's good. Tom Negovan is just back from Afghanistan, where he was embedded with Illinois troops there.
Yeah.
And I've been looking at the photographs and the videos that you've been posting on the TV website and watching your reports on WGN TV. It's fascinating. It brings a whole new perspective to that we have soldiers in conflict in this place. It somehow humanizes the story.
Yeah. And that was the idea, you know, Dean. I mean, we talked about this the other day. We did the morning news together Friday, and you and I had a chance to talk about it a little bit. And it really, that's what it's all about, bringing it home, bringing these soldiers and their stories home to their families just a little bit.
What were your first impressions as you stepped off the plane and, you know, you're in this place? You've done this sort of thing before, right, where you've gone into combat zones. It's not completely new to you.
It is not completely new or foreign to me, but this was a completely new and foreign experience because it's not like Iraq, you know. I mean, the level of poverty I saw immediately on arriving in Kabul was like nothing I'd ever seen before. There's just this sort of state of anarchy that pervades daily life there. Even a cab ride, you know, from the airport is an adventure, and you really feel that people sort of live their lives on the very edge there. And you've got to be a really tough, unique kind of person just to live and survive in Afghanistan. You probably won't thrive.
When you say it's an adventure, it's an adventure because there's a threat of military action while you're riding in the cab, or it's just a completely different environment and, you know, surreal kind of world compared to what we know, even by U.S. poverty standards.
Yeah, the last one by U.S. or almost any poverty standards. The poverty is very, very extreme. I mean, there's sewage running in the streets, and there are people begging by the side of the road and just dashing through traffic to get where they're going to do business, and without a real a lot of fear for their personal safety. Just you know, their life and death just take on a whole different dimension over there. I think the value we place on things is very, very much different. And certainly the threat of military action is always there. More the threat of insurgent action. I mean, it speaks to the mission that these Illinois National Guard soldiers are over there doing, because they're there mentoring the Afghan National Police and the Afghan National Army, sort of America's exit strategy from Afghanistan. So they're there helping the Afghan people to sort of stand up and take charge of their own affairs. And right now, there's this pervasive sense of lawlessness over there. Mm-hmm. Everywhere you look, there are no traffic rules or regulations or laws. People drive willy-nilly as they see fit, and I mean, there's very little regard for pedestrians or other traffic, and you just see that, and that's just sort of this one microcosm of life there, and it's sort of a metaphor for everything around it.
Yeah, that's just your drive from the airport.
Yeah,
pretty
yeah.
much. Wow. So, do you go to a hotel? Do you go to a military base?
This is the part that was pretty wild for me getting there, because you get to the airport in Kabul, and I had arranged for transport. A company called Afghan Logistics was going to take me from the airport to Bagram Airfield, which is where initially I needed to go. And I had connected with these Illinois soldiers, and they're like, you know what, no, stick with us, come with us. We have an amazing story to tell over here. And as they started to tell me that story, this trip evolved, and the storytelling I was going to do started to evolve. But they were going to pick me up at the airport, and things kind of went a little sideways when I got there. You get to the airport there, and they don't want you and your bags sticking around. You know, the police and security guys at the airport are like, okay, you got your stuff, got your bags, you all set? Okay, now get out.
Get out, yeah.
Yeah, and get moving and keep moving. So I hung around the airport as long as I could looking for my Illinois guys, and it's really unsafe, because you are an IED target if you're sitting there. I mean, make no mistake, as a Westerner, you are in trouble.
Hmm.
Even in Kabul, which is frankly the most civilized part of Afghanistan, no question the safest part, but it is still completely unsafe to be there on your own as a Westerner with all this stuff and nowhere to go. So I hung out as long as I could for about about 5 hours. And then the Afghan police weren't going to let me stay there anymore, you know, because I'm endangering them as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I just hopped in a cab.
So take me to the airbase?
Yeah, I said, look, there were some soldiers other than the Illinois guys who were expecting me at Bagram Airfield, about 48 miles north that afternoon. So I said, you know what, just take me up there. The guy didn't speak English, but he understood Bagram. Let's go. Mm-hmm. We went. This guy took me for this crazy Mad Max hell ride through through some really interesting back road areas, you know, the scenic route, you know, that I don't think a lot of folks see, the back roads up to the airfield. And it was an absolute eye-opener just to see the way people lived in that part of the world, yeah. In that part of the country.
Yeah.
The absolute poverty. It was, and I'm there, you know, 6 hours, and I had this incredible appreciation for what we have here. And it was eye-opening.
Yeah, I can only imagine. Let me take a quick break. When we come back, I want to talk more about what you learned by being embedded with Illinois troops, what you observed of the Taliban. Tom Negovan is here, just back from Afghanistan. Embedded with which troops there, Tom?
The Illinois National Guard. The Illinois National Guard, just shy of 3,000. They're in the largest deployment of Illinois National Guard troops since World War II. And it's a historic deployment and a historic mission as well. They're mentoring and retraining the police and army, working directly with Afghan nationals, with the Afghan people. So they're in every corner of that country, you know, including the most dangerous spots you can imagine, the most remote places that look like the end of the world. I was on one forward operation base about a week ago called Fob Warrior. And Fob Warrior is primarily a Polish base. It's about 250, just shy of 300 Polish soldiers. And the Polish troops historically team up with America ever since the end of the Cold War, but they mm-hmm. choose to partner with Illinois soldiers. You know, there's that connection between Chicago and Poland, obviously.
And
Chicago,
the large Polish population here, I guess.
Exactly, and that persists in the war zone. Yeah. That is so much evident over there, because ever since the Cold War, we've had this partnership with the Poles. And the Poles, when they are in a war zone, a conflict zone like Iraq, for example, or Afghanistan, they choose to partner with Illinois soldiers. So there are 250, 300 Polish troops, three American embeds on the entire base,
yeah.
And all three are members of the Illinois National Guard.
How are